Not only am I really infusing those flavors into my palate that's going to send them to my olfactory bulb up here that stores, it's like a little database storing all those flavors, all those scents for the rest of your life. So what you want to do is just saturate that palate, but at the same time, you're creating vapors that are going to send those scents up to through your nose to your olfactory bulb too. So you're kind of getting the double whammy of these flavors and scents to pick up and retain for the next time you taste this wine. So try doing that. Just take a sip, roll it around your mouth to a count of eight. That's me. And then swallow them and think about those flavors. Yeah. But you get some fruit up front. This one, you don't eat, there's no tannins, so you don't get the tannin. But you get all these flavors that are much more exaggerated, so you're able to think. And what I want you to do is think about, and the wine when you're tasting, these are all very young wines. Our wines are made to age, and then they round out and become much more mature fruit. Everything marries, and you have these great wines. But they're beautiful up front, but you have to know that. You have to look at the balance between, in this wine, between the acids and the oak and the fruit and see if those are going to age in simultaneously. Because if you have big fruit but no acids, I would say drink that wine because those acids are kind of the antioxidant antibacterial, like tannins do. They help a wine survive while it's aging and not falling apart. Okay? So that's the first one. Now, I'm going to pour the second wine, which is our reserve Chardonnay. Now, this, and everybody always says, what does reserve mean? It's all the concept, the winery and the winemaker. And I'll just tell you that reserve for us means it's the best grapes. These are our top grapes. And these are special because they're a special clone of Chardonnay called Dijon strain. Now, Dijon, France, it's a specific grape that is very tiny with such intensity that you're able to leave these in oak much longer and age them much longer, and they have just extraordinary depth. I always call this a cab drinker Chardonnay because it has everything a cab drinker, and this is the one that I could pull a lot of cab drinkers that do not like Chardonnays over to, because remember, it has oak. This is an extraordinary grape with such intensity, we leave it in oak barrels for 15 months, but it doesn't get overpowered by the oak. Everybody thinks that new oak means better. No, it doesn't, because it gives you the influence of the new oak, but remember, if you have your wine all in new oak barrels, you're going to have to pull it out of those barrels or it's going to be over-oaked. I don't care what fruit you have. So what we try here is to get balance of the new oak with the aging. So we'll use maybe 50% new, 10% 2, 20% 1-year-old barrels, 20% 3-year-old barrels, and then marry them back together at the end, and you've got this beautiful wine that you've been able to let age while you're infusing those flavors. So not all new is good, okay? Now, the other thing you have in here, even though it's very intense, you've got a creaminess to this. Does everybody know what the term malolactic means? Okay? Malolactic is a lot of people think, and they'll say it's secondary fermentation. And that's what a lot of people say, but it doesn't have anything to do with the fermentation, because fermentation to me denotes use of a yeast. And the second fermentation or a secondary fermentation would be creating a sparkling wine or champagne. Do a primary fermentation to transform sugars to alcohol, and now you have your base wines like Pinot Noir or Chardonnay. Now you're going to blend these into the cuvée. You're going to now bottle them. You're going to now want to put the sparkle in your wine. So you add a little sugar, a little yeast, put a bottle cap on, and let it ferment a second time. Now that one's, now it can't release the CO2. It's going to be embedded in your wine, and you're going to get a little higher alcohol level, and you create a sparkling wine. So this, to create that creaminess, we've all heard of buttery Chardonnays, that's malolactic. We've heard of big round reds, that's malolactic. It's converting one acid to another, malic to lactic, as in malolactic. Malic being the tart green apple flavors, lactic being the butter acids. So the more you transform from malic to lactic, the more buttery or creamy it's going to get. Red wines, you do 100%, because I've never heard anybody say, last night I had the most acidic, most tart red wine in my life. You don't hear that. You hear big, round, rich red, 100%. Depending on which white wine, if you want a nice, crisp, acidic, like barbecue wine, or a summer wine that you want to be refreshing, then you may not do any, or just a hint maybe to knock off the harsh malic acid, that harsh green apple. So just a hint. Then as you progressively go up to 10, 20, 30, 40, 50%, then you start getting into those buttery Chardonnays, but you also lose the life of the malic acid as you're going through. So your job as a winemaker is create balance. This one's about 17%. So 17%, we think, gives you a nice creaminess, but doesn't put in that buttery stage that we think is a negative. We want to have the vitality and the beauty of the fruit really showcasing the fruit. Okay? But 15 months of French oak, you wouldn't say this one is over-oaked. It's not. It's beautiful balance of oak and acids and fruit. So this one, 8 to 12 years you could age it, and it just gets so creamy and so beautifully vibrant, but those acids stay in context. Okay?